Hello and welcome to PDFSupply.com. Today we're going to be testing an RX3i Ethernet module. I have here an IC695ETM001. It's attached to an IC695CHS0077 slot rack. The processor I'm using for this test is an IC695 CPU320 and the power supply is an IC695 PSA040. So what we're going to do is test the Ethernet ports of the module. We're going to configure it and then test the ports. And in order to do that, what you're going to want to do is go to Proficy Machine Edition. If you guys are watching, I have this open right now. And I have an open blank file where I've configured the ETM001. If you follow where my mouse is right now, the arrow, I'm going to double click, or you can right click and hit configure, either way. And you can see that I've got the ETM001 set up in the settings under IP address. I've chosen an IP address that's something that's not currently configured on our network. So I've chosen my last three digits to be a lot higher than anything else that's on our network. That way I know that I'm only testing the ports on this particular module. All right, and then of course the subnet mask. So configure it with something that doesn't conflict with your network. And then we're going to connect up to the processor by clicking the lightning bolt icon. All right, once that's connected, I'm going to hit the green handprint, which puts us in programmer mode. Again, I'll show you down below if you follow my arrow. This status bar tells us that we're in programmer mode. It's stop, disabled, configuration not equal, logic not equal, and we're going to work on that. Same thing as all the processor tests. We're going to go to target, online commands, and we're going to clear controller and IO fault tables. This will keep us from getting hung up throughout the download process. And then download and run. Okay. Now, first thing it's going to ask us is what exactly do we want to download to the processor? And it'll be the first two selections, configuration and logic. All right, hardware configuration in motion and logic. We don't want to write anything to the permanent flash memory or anything else. Now, as this build is in progress, I also want to explain, I'm using COM port number 2. I'm using an HE693CBL232 cable, which is attached to the computer through the 9-pin serial port, and it's being adapted to the 15-pin port on my CPU320 using an HE693SNP232, okay? You can, of course, use COM port 1, and if you do use COM port 1, just keep in mind, if you're using this type of cable, you'll need a gender adapter. All right, now it's asking me if I'd like to start the controller or enable the outputs, and I do want to do that. Okay, now that it's in run mode and we've downloaded the IP address and subnet masked this Ethernet controller, we're going to want to ping it. So I'm going to go to my command prompt screen and I'm going to ask it to ping the address that I've configured for it. All right, now before I hit enter, I have a local Ethernet cable that's plugged in and I'm going to plug it to my port 1A. Of course, the first thing I'm going to look for is that the LEDs next to my cable are blinking. All right, make sure that you guys have that. I'm holding the cable in a certain way where I think you can see it right at the tip of my finger. You can see it reflecting off my finger. All right, that needs to be blinking. And then I'm going to hit enter. Of course, I'm going to hit enter after the LAN OK light is on or if it's blinking. That way I know if it's connected up. Now, after I hit enter, you guys can see I have an immediate reply. Four replies. It gives me the amount of information and the time it took. All right. And then, of course, we're going to check port number 2. or port 1B. Okay. Again, we plug it in, make sure that the LEDs are on and that the LAN OK light is blinking. That means it's connected up and it sees it. Now I'm going to hit my up key, my up arrow key, and it's going to give me the same function, ping 192.168.1.219. I'm going to hit enter. Okay, I got four replies, four out of four, that's perfect. So I know that these ports are working, I know that this module is a working module. Then I'm going to go ahead and unplug it. I'm going to hit my up arrow key again. Of course, that may not make sense at first. I can hit enter. Now what I'm doing here is I'm just testing my test procedure. So if for some reason somebody has established something on our network that ends with 219, as you see my IP address here, I may accidentally or inadvertently be pinging something I don't intend to ping, and it's telling me that this is okay, and I might be getting a false reading. So what I do every time I test an Ethernet module is I unplug all my ports, I use the same address, I ping it, and if I don't get a reply, that means that I know for sure I've only been testing this particular module and nothing else, okay? Troubleshooting. So if you guys power this up just like you would with a CPU and you don't get an Ethernet okay or a module okay after it's gone through its self-diagnostic, that typically means that there's something drastically wrong with this unit. You wouldn't be able to configure it and you certainly wouldn't be able to follow this test. Okay. Another thing that could happen is if you have an arrangement of lights that are blinking in unison, that sometimes means that somebody's held down the Ethernet restart button too long and they've inadvertently put it into firmware upgrade mode. Okay, that's something to be aware of, and that's exactly what that blinking in unison light pattern means. It means that it's ready for an update. Okay, any of these things would require potential replacement or certain repair or an upgrade. Okay. So if that's something that's happened to your unit, we do repair these quite often at PDF Supply. We offer exchange programs, new and remanufactured products, and same day shipping. So if that's something that you need or interests you, please see us at pdfsupply.com. Thank you.